Automotive belts use a few part number systems that can be decoded with ease once you finish this video. Now, if you live in the US, most belts you'll be dealing with will be measured in inches, but don't worry, everyone else in the world, metric belts will be covered here too. There are two common numbering systems for belts measured in inches, so if you memorize both of them, you can deal with most of the brands out there. These are name brands that use the format where the first number seems to only be a brand distinguishing number, followed by two digits that count the number of ribs, then four digits that tell how long the belt is in inches, with the last of those digits being a decimal. Let's break that down with an example, because that description may be confusing without some visual aid. Here's a Dayco belt for my GTO. The first number here, 5, we can ignore. As far as I've seen, every basic Dayco belt starts with that number. Every Continental belt starts with 4, Goodyear starts with 1, Gate starts with K, elastic belts start with E, and Dayco belts with ribs on both sides start with 6. I only start with that because it's the first number, but unless you're looking for a particular belt brand, it's the least useful number. The second of the two numbers are the rib count, so this 06 means ribs. Those are these lines that run the length of the belt that line up with the grooves on some of the pulleys, which work together to keep the belt from sliding off. If you have a belt with too many ribs, it won't fit on the ribbed pulleys. If you get one with too few, it probably won't be able to handle all the stress put on it. Automakers are always trying to get more fuel efficiency out of a vehicle, so if they could get away with a smaller belt, they would. Plus, a 5-rib belt can't sit centered on a 6-rib pulley, so that would put uneven stress on the pulley bearings. All that is to say, if you have a 6-rib belt on your car, stick with a 6-rib belt. You may have noticed that there's a 0 before the number of ribs. While most personal vehicles will have up to 8 ribs on their belts, there are belts out there on heavier duty applications that get into double-digit rib territory. Alright, the final number cluster. This is the length of the belt in inches down to the tenth of an inch. This belt is 77.5 or 77.5 inches long. A belt that reads 5060123 would be a Dayco belt with 6 ribs that is 123.4 inches long. Pretty easy, right? These belts always have a placeholder 0 at the beginning and end, so there's no confusion about where the decimal place will be. That's the first one, but you probably get now that the belt information is turned into a part number, and this next one is going to apply that same philosophy. This numbering system is used by a few brands, including a lot of auto parts store brands. It will start with the number of ribs, so let's go with the GTO example again, which will start with 6. Next will be a placeholder, which is quite often the letter K. And then the last digits are the length of the belt. The slightly tricky thing about this one is that if the belt is shorter than 100 inches, say maybe 77.5, the part number tends to not have the 0 placeholder, so anything over 100 inches will end in 4 digits, while anything shorter will end in 3 digits. Luckily, if the belt is something 0.0 inches, the part number will still end with a 0. Those were in inches, so what about metric belts? Those are usually built around the industry standard PK number, which you can even see on my GTO belt here. Bando seems to use that number exactly as is for their part numbering system, while other brands may add some letters and numbers before or after it to make it their own. For example, this Michelin belt starts with a bunch of letters, but ends in that PK number. Much like the previous belt size number, the first digit is the number of ribs, then there's PK, which tells you it's the PK number, then you get the effective length of the belt in millimeters. The effective length is a little more specific than the length, but those details are beyond the scope of this video. This GTO belt's PK number says it has 6 ribs and has an effective length of 1,970 millimeters. Now that we understand those three basic numbering systems, we can use them to our advantage to find special belts that might not have been listed properly by a retailer. For example, the normal Gates part number for the Serpentine belt on the Crosstrek is KO60598, but if you add the letters HD to the end, now you have the Fleet Runner version, which is supposed to outlast the normal version. Plus, it's green, which says to anyone looking under the hood, this is not the stock belt. Gates also has an RPM line of belts that end in RB, but they have different stretch properties and shouldn't be thrown on for fun. They behave differently, and you need to know what you're doing before you install one. The part numbering systems we've covered so far will help you with most aftermarket brands, but OEM brands, they have internal part numbering systems that are far more complex, so that's beyond the scope of this video. However, armed with this knowledge, you should be able to look at cross-reference sheets and be able to make more confident decisions. Sometimes part stores and online retailers have listing errors, and being able to spot an oddball part number may save you from having to return a part. Also, some vehicles have more than one belt, and a lot of part lookup systems don't distinguish between the various belts, forcing you to read the application details before every single belt. For example, the GTO belt I've been using in this entire video isn't the only belt on the engine. There's also a small length 4-rib belt that runs from the crank to the AC compressor between an idler and tensioner pulley. If you look up a belt for a 2005 Pontiac GTO on a website, you'll be able to find the air conditioning belt right away without having to click on each one to see the details. It does get a little less easy if your particular car came with multiple drive belt system options, so be aware of those potentially small differences. I remember there being a truck with a few model years where you had to know if you had no AC, factory AC, or dealer installed AC. Imagine owning a secondhand truck and being asked at the parts counter if your AC came from the factory or the dealer. Now that you understand the belt part numbering system, you may be looking to install a new belt. We've got you covered with a belt installation video on the screen here, or you can check out what YouTube thinks is the best option for you over here. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to use the comments section if you have any questions. Here's a Dayco belt for my GTO. The first number here, 5, we can ignore. Where's my Dayco belt?